Welcome to my channel. I'm your SPARX stenographer. Today I'm going to dictate a KAILASH CHANDRA magazine volume 1 and transcription number 21. And guys, don't forget to subscribe my channel and also join me on WhatsApp. So get ready. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. Start. Now coming back to the question of minorities, you will please find why this particular resolution has been so widely put in that it might include a religious minority as well a linguistic minority as well, or an economic minority, as some honorable members rightly pointed out. Now, sir, a question arises whether there ought to be any such protection insofar as a particular type of minority is concerned. I shall deal with the question of minorities at some length, but you will please find what the honorable mover wants to, that there ought to be a permanent minorities commission. It ought to be endowed with statutory powers. Therefore, sir, an attempt is being made for the first time by my honorable friend for driving a wedge between a community and a community. So far as the constitution is concerned, as my honorable friend rightly pointed out, whenever the question of minorities arises, we have to be extremely careful. The constitution is very scared document which has embodied all the difficult aspects of the common question of India's nationality. India is one in spite of different types of languages and religions, but in the midst of all these diversities, we have to develop a common nationality. Therefore, whenever we consider the question of the development of the nation and the interest of the nation, you cannot afford to think in terms either of religion or of language. It is true, sir, that there are different religions. It is also true that there are different languages. Therefore, a question arose, and the farmers of the constitutions had a device, a constitution in the midst of the unity of India with certain diversities here and there. For that purpose, what they did was they devised a common nationality for the whole of India, and in so far as religious minorities were concerned, they were given certain rights. I would not go into the details regarding the provisions of the fundamental rights regarding the practice of religion. Certain rights have been given to the religious minorities, and beyond that it would not be proper to bring in the religious minorities for political rights. For that we have to be extremely careful. I would also point out that while we have to develop a common nationality, the members of the Indian nation have to understand that we are one nation. Therefore, certain rights in respect of religious minorities were given. They were fundamental rights, and most of them are justiciable rights. Here we stopped so far as the religious rights were concerned. Then a question arose: what ought to be the attitude of not only the government but the society regarding the languages? It was true that there were certain interests of the religion languages. Now, these languages required to be developed, but they were not seemed for dividing one man from the other. So, in 1956, when the states were formed to be a certain extent on the basis of language, what was done was not to have a state with 100% people belonging to the religion language, because there were bound to be people belonging to different languages. That was the reason why this question was considered at a great length and the State Reorganization Commission also went into this question of linguistic minorities. It was bound to arise here and there because they were likely to feel that their rights and safeguards given to them might or might not be properly implemented. So, this question was considered first by the State Reorganization Commission, and they dealt with the question whether we should have a permanent majority commission. They went into it very carefully and surely. They found out that it would not be proper to set up a permanent minorities commission because the result, if not the actual effect, would be that a permanent wedge would be driven between one community and another community. So far as language minorities were concerned, they had a right so far as their own languages were concerned. They had also an obligation to understand the language of majority in the particular state. It is only by thus coming together that the members of the two language groups would come together and would harmoniously develop. But it was found at the time when the State Reorganization Commission had to consider that some machinery should be devised for safeguarding the rights of linguistic minorities only and after full consideration. What was considered was that only in respect of linguistic minorities, certain rights should be extended and certain rights should be safeguarded, and an officer should be appointed by the president for making a report on the question whether these rights of the linguistic minorities are not properly safeguarded.